miles from nowhere. Guess I'll take my time. Oh yeah. To reach there, look up at the mountain I have to climb. Oh yeah. To reach there, Lord, my body has been a good friend, but I won't need it when I reach the end. Miles from nowhere, I guess I take my time.
Planned this backpacking trip to the High Sierras above Mammoth Lakes, California, back in March of 2018 to enter the trailhead at Agnew Meadows on September 11th. But about a week before I was supposed to head out, there was high winds in the High Sierras, so I had to cancel my overnight permits to stay at Ediza Lake and Thousand Island Lakes. And instead, I waited and watched the winds die down, and by September 16th, they're calm enough that I had to go in person and apply for available permits down at the ranger station at the Welcome Center down below. So I had to wait till like 11 o'clock, got the permit, thank goodness, and then headed back up to Agnew Meadows, got a campsite there. And after I got the campsite, I went ahead and went to the Devil's Post Pile. I had never been there before. It's a neat geological formation. There's also waterfalls in the area. So very easy to get to and really cool to see. So I'll show you some photos of that. Rainbow Falls, beautiful. Well, I'm here at the Devil's Post Pile. Hexagon of stone. A whole cliff. Amazing. I think they have the giant causeway there in Ireland. Here's a map of the Ansel Adams Wilderness area and the trails that are there to take. The trail that I had chosen was to take Shadow Creek, starting at the Agnew Meadows trailhead here in red, Shadow Creek Trail. Took that up, went about a half mile past Olane Lake. You make a left, you do a number of switchbacks to go very high in elevation to Shadow Lake right here. And then you cross the John Muir Trail and keep on going out toward Ediza Lake. And here's Ediza Lake. John Muir himself said that some of the most beautiful scenery he ever saw in the High Sierra was the transition from Agnew Meadows all the way up to Ediza Lake, and it'd be hard to argue with. I stayed overnight at Ediza Lake and then retraced my steps going back that way, and then came to the John Muir Trail and took that north. heading to Garnet Lake. There was a very high ascent to Garnet Lake, probably over 10,000 foot in elevation was the peak there. Kept going to past Ruby Lake, and then past Emerald Lake, and then on to Thousand Island Lake, which was my destination for the night. Camping is only allowed on the north-east side of the lake, so you had to walk quite a bit to get a campsite. I stayed there at night. It was wonderful. Great scenery right there. The next day, got up early, headed back down along the lake trail, crossed the John Muir Trail, got on the Pacific Crest Trail for a short period of time, took that to the River Trail. The River Trail is highlighted here kind of in yellow-orange color. The River Trail was wonderful for me to take because it was primarily downhill, all forest covered, running near the San Joaquin River. And I'll tell you, I was just skipping down this trail. It was so much easier than going up. I really enjoyed the trip all the way back to Agnew Meadows. It's always good to go, but it's nice to get back. Well, hiking along Shadow Creek, come across a couple of bristlecone pines, the oldest living thing on the planet. They can live to be 4,000 years old. Pretty amazing. Well, I'm on the Shadow Creek Trail. I wasn't too sure for a while, but I'm glad to see this sign right behind me as Two Shadow Lake. So, right trail, thank goodness. Well, I came to a beautiful bridge behind me here that they put up. Amazing they put something like this up. Alrighty then. Well, not much water flowing in this creek here to warrant such a gigantic bridge. Must flow pretty hard at times, huh? Beautiful in here, surrounded by shade trees and mountains everywhere. A good switchback climb out of that valley down below, heading to Shadow Lake. Still got more to go. There's the valley. Gotta head up at some point. Well, hopefully that's the outlet for Shadow Lake. It's been a heck of a climb of switchbacks to this point. So I'll be glad to make it to the top. Hopefully it just flattens out over that waterfall. And on top of the outlet to Shadow Lake is beautiful. And the mountains just keep going up and up and up and up all the way that far pinnacle. Well, there's the view of Shadow Lake. Made it to the top, hopefully it flattens out. Here's the outlet below me. It's got a long way to travel down the hill. Come on down. Well, I'm saying goodbye to Shadow Lake. This is the inflow into Shadow Lake. It's beautiful. It opens up into the lake. All right, maybe I'll make it back this way again, Shadow Lake.
Well, I'm never gonna finish this walk because they keep stopping to take pictures around every corner. It's incredible. What's on the trail up ahead here? Got rushing water. More beautiful waterfalls all the way up. Well, I'm about 2 miles from Ediza Lake. Looks like it's going to be a little colder here than I thought. Well, it looks like a patch of snow in a couple of places. Well, made it to Ediza Lake. A lot harder than I thought. Some tall peaks around here. Well, this is a stream that I come down and get my water here at Ediza Lake. It's only about 100 feet away from my campsite. Nice view. Well, I'm hiking the same trail back from Ediza Lake, heading to Garnet Lake and Thousand Island Lakes, and I can't believe how different the view is just walking the opposite direction. Beautiful though. Peaks, forests. Awesome. Well, as I was hiking up this trail here, I was thinking of one of my favorite movies, Little Big Man. I always remember the old Indian chief, and the line he would have was, "It would make my heart soar like an eagle." And it's so beautiful here, it reminds me of that. Beautiful. There's another line I remember though. It's kind of fun. Little Big Man said, "I ain't just playing Injun, I'm living Injun." And I get a little sense of that here as well. Well, I hope this is the top of some pass into Garnet Lake. I'm on the John Muir Trail. Caught it at the intersection from Ediza. I'm heading on to Thousand Island Lakes and stay the night there. Met already a couple of backpackers. Yeah, there. One woman was hiking from Sonora. Unbelievable. I'm glad I'm out just 2 nights. Well, catching a good glimpse of Garnet Lake. Beautiful how it opens up here. At least I hope it's Garnet Lake. I guess I'll find out. Well, here's another look. Garnet Lake. It's crystal clear water at the shorelines. A mountain with snow on it at the peak. The wind's blowing pretty good. Well, just coming on Ruby Lake. Off the John Muir Trail. Saw a lot of hikers on the trail. Probably more than a dozen. Well, here I am at Emerald Lake. It's about a half hour away from where I'm camping at Thousand Island Lakes. I can see why they call it Emerald Lake. Beautiful. And there's the trail ahead of me. 5 more miles, maybe. Well, made it to Thousand Island Lakes. Beautiful behind me. A little bit of snow on some of the higher elevations. Still haven't made it to my campsite. Heading that direction though. Well, I'm on the river trail heading to Agnew Meadows. I'm probably only about an hour out. I was just reflecting on the walk. It's just been wonderful. 3 days backpacking in the High Sierras. It's everything I imagined and a number of things I couldn't possibly imagine. I'm a much stronger person for doing the hike. I think I have calves of steel. But it was very strenuous. The first 2 days up to Ediza Lake and then on to Thousand Island, it was very hard on me. But I've been skipping my way down this river trail. It's been downhill. It's just been wonderful, and it's just so beautiful in here. The weather's cool and no bugs. What a great park. I think I'll be back another day to try another trail.